Take a fork and pull it up.
Fanny Craddock was one of TV's first celebrity chefs. From the 1950s to the 70s, millions tuned in as she prepared her culinary delights, often in partnership with her devoted husband, Johnny.
There's your gin, darling.
Oh, thank you, my love. Must you give me away?
Fanny was the toast of the nation, but behind the heavily made-up smile was a complicated private life. Fanny was married four times in all, Johnny being her last husband. She had two children by her earlier husbands, Peter and Christopher. But curiously, when she died in 1994, neither of them was mentioned in her will. When Fanny died, she was worth around £200,000. She left £150,000 of that to a charity for blind children. But £50,000 went to Philip Bradford and Terence John Hibbert. That's about £100,000 in today's money. So why did Fanny leave Christopher and Peter out of her will? And who were Philip Bradford and Terence Hibbert, the mysterious recipients of such a generous bequest? Jane Chapman was married to Fanny's son, Christopher, who died last year. She first met Fanny as a friend of her parents.
When I was leaving school and didn't know what to do next, she suggested I went up and lived with her in London. Living with Fanny was great fun. I met lots of famous people. She had lots of dinner parties. She took me everywhere with her. She looked on me as the daughter that she never had.
Now the part that the housewife is so scared of because of the rubbish that's been written in some of these women's magazines.
She was very kind to me, but she could also be very brutal to people.
Bang that down.
Fanny had a troubled relationship with both her sons. Jane only met Christopher when he was briefly reconciled with Fanny after a long estrangement.
Fanny saw Christopher and I kissing under the mistletoe at Christmas. So when we got together, I thought that to be a daughter-in-law, I thought she would have liked the idea. She didn't approve. I was disappointed when I left. I told her that one day she was going to be a very sad, lonely old lady, which she was.
Jane and Christopher got married in 1966, and that was the last they saw of Fanny. She also lost touch with her other son, and neither appeared in her will.
I wasn't at all surprised that neither Christopher or his brother Peter were mentioned in her will. Peter and Pam left under the same sort of circumstances to Christopher and I. They never had any more contact with her either.
I'm not dead yet. There's plenty of life in me.
In the 1970s, Fanny met two men who would become like sons to her, Philip Bradford and Terence Hibbert. They were later named in her will. Evangeline Evans was Fanny's lifelong friend.
Philip Terry came into her life because they ran a restaurant. And so she and Johnny went to the restaurant and immediately fell in love with them. And the boys really loved them back.
Fanny met Terry and Phil when she was at the top of her game. But in 1976, she committed a terrible faux pas live on TV. Fanny was asked to comment on the culinary efforts of likeable Devon housewife, Gwen Troke. Fanny was clearly disgusted.
A seafood cocktail. And then straight into the dark.
Today, entire TV careers are built around criticizing wannabe chefs. Back then, it just wasn't done. Fanny's career was over. And in 1987, her beloved Johnny died.
She was kind of desolate, and the boys just remained faithful to her. They just gathered her up. I can't admire them enough or like them enough for having done that.
Their reward was to be remembered in her will. Did that surprise you?
Not a bit. I was just so terribly glad. And that's one of the very best things she ever did, I think, was to leave them her money.
Fanny Craddock blazed a trail for all the celebrity chefs working today. Her personal life may have been fraught with problems, but at the end, it seems she found an adoptive family who made her last years happy ones.
It's been lovely being back with you. Thank you so much for watching.